Wonderful. Good afternoon and welcome to another Object Talk Live. My name is Shireen and I am delighted to be hosting today's session. Now, as I'm sure many of you are aware, Object Talks are an opportunity for you all at home to learn something new about an object from our collection, or sometimes objects. We have over 40,000 objects at the Jewish Museum London. And every week, we like to share at least one of them with you. Now, this month at the Jewish Museum London, we have been focusing on the theme of fun and entertainment. And what better topic to discuss than the Olympic Games? Now, of course, the Olympics of 2020 in Tokyo just finished on the 8th of August. And what fun they were, despite the changes that took place due to COVID. Britain won over 65 medals this year, making Tokyo our second most successful overseas Olympics after Rio 2016. We claimed 22 golds, 21 silvers, and 22 bronze medals in Japan. Furthermore, across all the international Olympic teams, there were many Jewish players, including the US women's basketball star Sue Bird, Ethiopian Israeli runner Maru Tafiri, Australian race walker Gemma Montag, and Mizrahi French Paralympian Ezra French. But what about British Jewish Olympians? Now, there have been many British Jewish Olympians throughout history, including David Henry Jacobs, who was the first British Jew to win an Olympic gold medal in the 1912 Stockholm Olympics. And also, how about the 1920s Olympic champion, Harold Abrahams, who won the 100 metre in a time of 10.6 seconds. But for today's object talk, I would like to focus on someone in particular. I would like to focus on Sir Ben Helfgott. Now, I will share my screen and then we will begin to explore some of the objects that celebrate Sir Ben Helfgott's story. Now, Sir Ben Helfgott has a very interesting story and a very important connection to the Olympics through weightlifting. But despite his role in the Olympics and many other games, his childhood did not necessarily or was not necessarily marked by fun, but by sadness and loss. Now, shortly before Ben's 10th birthday on September the 1st, 1939, the Nazis invaded Poland, marking the beginning of the Second World War. This would be the start of many harrowing years for Ben and his family, and many of his loved ones were murdered in the Holocaust. In December 1944, Ben was sent to Buchenwald concentration camp, along with his father, in a transport of only 300 men. Sadly, after 2 weeks, Ben was separated from his father and sent to another concentration camp to work. In April 1945, he was taken to Theresienstadt in Czechoslovakia. The war was nearing its end and Ben was liberated 3 weeks later. But unfortunately, his father was murdered. Around this time, the British government had agreed to take on 1,000 young concentration camp survivors in order for them to be rehabilitated all over the UK. But only 732 youngsters could be found, including Ben. This group of young Jewish survivors, mainly boys, were named the Boys. There were three groups altogether, and Ben was in the first group, who was taken to Windermere. Miraculously, Ben and his sister Marla were reunited in 1947 in England, where they both now live. Now, Ben started a new life in Windermere. He was, after years of horror and abuse, treated with kindness and respect. He started his sporting life in England as soon as he arrived, playing football, volleyball, and going swimming. He was extremely passionate about sports from a very young age. It was in his blood. He started playing table tennis at around 8 years old and was also a keen gymnast. Now, he went to school to restart his education, which was abruptly stopped in 1939, going on to study economics at Southampton University in 1949. But how did he get into weightlifting? Now, Sir Ben Helfgott got into weightlifting by chance. In the summer of 1947, during one of his regular visits to Hampstead Heath Ponds, he bumped into a few people lifting weights. He was intrigued. This would be the first of many times he had a go at lift weighting. And the lift waiters, or the weight lifters, I should say, were in awe and commented that it seemed that Ben had lifted weights for a while. He was a natural. And from then on, due to the encouragement, he began training. Excited by this newfound interest in weightlifting, he returned to his home sports club, the Primrose Club, and asked the club leader if they could start some weightlifting sessions. Now, of course, the leader said yes. And so a Primrose Club weightlifting section was born. Ben continued to show a natural aptitude for weightlifting, and by 1950 was trying out for the British Maccabee team. Now, he was at Southampton University by this point, but continued to train. And he actually went on to win the competition and had and his second and third competition as well. Now, inspired by his victory, he began to train more seriously. And 10 years later, after first arriving to England after the Holocaust, he represented his newfound home country, Britain, in the 1956 Summer Olympics in Melbourne. 4 years later, he represented Britain once again in the Olympics in Rome. On both of his Olympic appearances, he was the captain of the British weightlifting team. And on our screen, you will be able to see a picture of Ben Helfgott in Rome Olympics in the 1960s. Now, beyond the Olympics, he became champion in the 1954 in the featherweight division and was later three times national lightweight champion in 1955, 56, and 58. He also won a bronze medal in 1958 British Commonwealth Games held in Cardiff, to which you can see a picture on the screen. He was also three times a champion at the Maccabee Games. When asked which of his achievements made him most proud, he said that he never particularly set out to be a champion weightlifter, and much of the time in his career was his priority, fulfilling his career beyond weightlifting. But he would consistently train for three evenings a week. However, he suggests that becoming British champion for the first time and then representing the British community at the Olympics for the first time were the two things that meant the most to him. Sir Ben Helfgott's contribution to the British weightlifting scene was nothing short of impeccable, inspiring, entertaining, and contributing masses to the British society. On June the 8th, 2018, his great services were rewarded as he was knighted in recognition, not only of his contributions to sport, but specifically towards his contribution to services to Holocaust remembrance and education. At the Jewish Museum London, we are grateful to have images and objects of Sir Ben Helfgott, all which represent so much for us at the museum, the Jewish community, sporting community, British community, and much beyond. Now, thank you for joining me today to hear the story of Sir Ben Helfgott. Do be sure to tune in next Wednesday for our next object talk. And also, do not forget, our museum doors are now open, so please be sure to join us on site too. But until then, I hope you have a great day. Thank you.